Hi everyone, Paul here from TechLink, and as I mentioned in the comment section of my previous video on how to recover your Discord account if you lost your two-factor authentication, there is a new way to do this which I'm about to show you in this video. So yeah, this is it, the moment you've all been waiting for. But before we go any further, I would like to introduce you to DJRT, who's been kind enough to sponsor this video. Their Winix HD video converter software is an all-in-one solution for video processing, so you can now convert, edit and compress 4K videos without losing the quality while reducing the file size by up to 90%. I'll leave a link in the description below so you can check out the software for yourself. Now, if you are new to the channel or haven't seen my previous video on how to recover your Discord account if you lost your two-factor authentication, I strongly recommend you to do so. The methods I shown in there are the ones you should try first. They are basic steps you should follow in order to recover your Discord account if you lost your 2FA. If that didn't work, only then you should try the method shown in this video, which is more like an update as it hasn't been available till recently. So let's cut the and get right into it. Now, the first thing you want to do is head over to their website on discord.com and select support from these tabs. You then need to click on submit a request and fill in all the details that I'm about to show you. So select hacked account from this drop down menu and fill up all the tabs. You need to insert first your email address, then your username and this tag number, which looks like hashtag and other four digits. If you don't remember it, you could ask one of your friends to find it for you. They should be able to see it if they click on your username in the Discord app. Again, you need to insert the email that was linked to your account. Now, it is very important that it matches the one that you insert in the first tab and also that you have access to it, as they will send you further instructions to this email. So unless you can access your email, they won't be able to help you. From the next drop-down menu, you need to select I clicked on a link. Did you receive an email from Discord explaining your account's associated email address was recently changed? Select no. Are you able to log in to the account? Select no again. And in here, was 2FA enabled on the account by the hacker? Select yes. Now in the subject tab, you need to write reset two-factor authentication, and in the description tab you need to write something like this: Hi, I believe my account has been compromised as I can no longer log in because I do not have access to the two-factor authentication. Can you please reset it so I can access back my account? Once you've done that, press submit and that's it. Discord support team will get back to you on your email, so make sure to check it for an answer. Now, this could take minutes or a few days, I'm not really sure, but you should get back a reply from them. Once you receive it, it will look something like this: thanks for reaching out, blah blah blah. In order for us to proceed with this investigation, we will need to temporarily suspend access to your account. So what you need to do is reply to this email and allow them to disable your account. Once you've done that, you should receive another email that looks like this: thank you for the confirmation. I've disabled your account and removed the two-factor authentication requirement. Now, before you can finally access your account, you need to click on the link provided by them or simply head over to their website. Insert your credentials and use the forgot your password feature. A new email will be sent to you with instructions on how to reset your Discord's account password. So once you do that, you can finally access back your account. Now that you regained access to your Discord account, you should definitely activate the two-factor authentication again, as it is the best way to protect it from being accessed by unwanted users. If you're not sure how to do it, I posted a video with the whole process for both mobile and PC, so make sure to check it out. With this being said, it's time to end this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. And if you would like to see other similar tutorials, please subscribe to the channel. And like always, thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.